Hi, welcome back. In this video, we're going to review the Light project in the App Development with Swift course. You can check out the project in the book, and here I'm going to go through all of these items. So I'm just going to put that to the side, and let's go ahead and open Xcode. Here I'm using Xcode 10, or Xcode X, as I like to call it. I don't call it that. And so choose create a new Xcode project. We want a single view app, and we're going to choose next. Let's give this a name, and we're going to call this Light. You've got your organization name, you've got your organization identifier, which is typically your reverse domain. We're going to use Swift, and we're not going to deal with core data or unit tests right now. Go ahead and choose next. Let's find a place to save this. Go ahead and click Create. Here we're presented with our default template. And the first thing we want to do, let's go to the main.storyboard, double click that to open it. And let's add a button. Now, remember in Xcode 10, they've moved everything. Because why not? Why not? Just change it since, you know, people have been using this for 10 years. Why remain the same? Anyway, it's up here and it's called Library and you select that. And if you haven't already, you know, it'll remember what you've done in the past. So here, if I just go ahead and filter, I can just say buttons. And let's grab a button and drag it to the screen. So now I can place this, and notice when I move this around, I've got some margins that automatically, now I don't have to set it at the margin, I can be rebellious and I can place it all the way against the edge, but this is going to show you some best practices, so keep that in mind as you work with it. So let's take a look at the this. Now I'm so old that this used to be called Interface Builder, which was a whole separate app from actually the Xcode editor. Interface Builder would launch as its own app. Anyway, ignore the old man. So here we've got a few things going on. We have a visual representation of a device, right? So if you look down here, it says view as, and it says iPhone 8. If I click that, notice all these other things. Look, I can select and say, oh, well, what will this look like, you know, on the 4S? Or what is this, the SE, or the 8, or the 8 plus, or the 10, or 10S, 10R, 10X max. Look at that. And then you got iPad, and now this is starting to not fill this, you know, it's overfilling the screen, so I can change my view, so I can zoom in or zoom out so I can see this a little better. Got, what is this, the iPad Pro 10.5 inch and the iPad Pro 12.9 inch. Look at that. Look at that. So this is a good way to get a visual sense of how things will look, but it's always best to test on a device. So be sure to buy 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 devices in order to develop for Apple. Okay, you don't necessarily have to buy all 10, but you should have at least an iPad and an iPhone. Okay, this gives us options to show orientation. So if I click orientation, things like that, you can get a sense for how it feels. Very good. Okay, let's just go back to the iPhone 8 and let's look at portrait. And let's zoom back in so we can see this. Okay. We want to give this button something to do. So, for example, let's run this. Go ahead and select Light and choose the iPhone 8 and then click Run. This is going to launch the iOS simulator and it's going to give us a visual, another representation of the iPhone 8. So here it is, and notice we have our little button, and hey, look, I clicked the button. Well, nothing's happening. nothing's happening because we haven't done anything. We haven't given it any code to do. So let's go back and click stop. And the way this works is you've got your storyboard that has visual elements, and the visual elements represent things you can interact with or display. And behind each of these, so here we have, notice over here in this hierarchy view, we've got, if this is closed, you can always twirl it open. And when you click on something, it's going to highlight where it is and in what relation it is to each other. So in other words, we have a view controller. Inside that view controller is a view object. Inside the view object is a button, and that's where this is. So this gives us a hierarchy, and as you add more elements to your layout, they'll show up here. In order to connect this to our view controller, notice when I select, if I select the top here, and I come over to my inspector, it says class view controller. So this is directly tied to this viewcontroller.swift file. One way to connect things is to open what is called the assist editor, which lets you see side by side the video, what am I saying? The integration, I want to call it the interface builder, but no one will let me anymore. Here's your visual side and here's your code side. So now they're side by side. Now this editor is smart enough that if you have multiple view controllers, when you select the view controller, it's going to select the correct source code that connects to it. We'll see that in other videos. But for now, here we are. If I want to make a connection, when I right click, then it gives me a bunch of options that say, hey, when I touch the button, when the button is down, when the button, all sorts of different actions, and I can click and drag, and I can create a method that gets called when the button is pressed. That's one way to do it. The other way is to press Control and click and drag. Now I'm still holding Control and I'm dragging with my mouse, and notice what happens. It allows me to insert, and it says insert outlet action or outlet collection. So I'm going to go ahead and release both the button and the mouse, and now it gives me a few options. We can check action, outlet, or outlet collection. I want action. And from here, I want to say button pressed, and then go ahead and click connect. Now, let's go ahead and add some space around this so we can see it. Go in and add some space. Okay, what we've done is we've created an action outlet that connects between this button and this code. When I press this button, this code will get executed, right? It'll be called. Notice that this little indicator is filled in, and when I mouse over it, it says, hey, that's what it is. If you have a lot of elements on your screen, in this view controller, you had a lot of buttons, a lot of image views, all sorts of things, you're gonna have a number of little connections. Well, you need to know which one is which, and the other thing that you'll do is you'll get used to seeing this, and you'll see, oh, this is connected, and so it's, when this button is pressed, it's going to call this code. Now let's run this and see when this gets called. There are a couple of ways you can test when this action gets called. One, you can put a breakpoint. If I mouse over the line number and I press once, I now have a breakpoint. Let's see what that does. Let's go ahead and click run. This is going to launch in the simulator. I want to move this over, and you'll see Xcode here, and there's stuff going on in this output window. Go ahead and press the button, and as soon as you press the button, it takes you right back to Xcode, and it stops right at the breakpoint. So this tells me that this is connected properly. Go ahead and click stop. And of course now it's moved all the windows and it's gone back to things. What it did is it changed to what is called a debug view, where it's showing you all the source code connected to this, and So if we're now, and notice here on the tabs, it says debug section, debug navigator. That's where we are right now. We want to go back to the project navigator. Go back to project navigator and click main storyboard. So now we're back to where we were. Okay, that's one way to test whether your button is connected. You have a breakpoint. If you click the breakpoint once, it's going to disable it. And if you click it again, it'll enable it. If you right click, you can say delete breakpoint. Or if you click, so I just create a new one. Watch this. If I click and drag away, it basically deletes it. Okay. The other way you could do this is to say print you pressed me. Now let's run this again, and I click run. Launches my app in the simulator. Now when I press button, check it out. Notice in the output it says you pressed me. We use the print method to print to the console. This is something that's very helpful for debugging. Breakpoints are probably the better way to do it, but if you're old school like me, good old print works great. All right, let's go ahead and we'll go back to Xcode and click stop. And let's go ahead and delete this line because we don't really need it. All right, when the button is pressed, we want to know whether the light should be on or off. In order to track that, we can create a variable that we can then use to say light is on or light is off. So if I click above within my class, within these curly braces here, I'm going to give myself a little more space, and I'm going to say var light on equals true. This is a variable that I can then modify to based on when I press the button. So to do that, let's go to within the button pressed method, and I'm going to say light on, and I'm just going to press tab. Notice the autocomplete. I'm just going to press tab. And this is a simple way to reverse the value of this Boolean by saying exclamation point light on. What this means is that I am assigning the value of light on to the opposite of whatever light on is. So if light on is true and I click the button, now I'm saying I want the opposite. When I use this exclamation point, I'm using the opposite. It's saying it's basically the negative or opposite value of whatever this is. So now when I press it, it'll change that back and forth. Well, that's all nice and everything, but in order for us to do something about it, to make an action that is visible, we're going to change the background color of this view. So you remember, if I click back over here and let me give myself a little more room. So when I am working within the visual elements, remember I said over here in the hierarchy of this view controller, there is this view. When I select it, it's this background, and it is the root container for this object. This root container, and it's a visual object, and right now the background is white. So if I come over here to my inspector, I can change some properties. Well, here is one that says background, and you can change that to different colors. I don't want to change that here. I want to change it programmatically, meaning I want to change it in code. So I can reference this view. This already exists in your view controller. There's already a reference to view. When we added the button, we had to add a reference to the button in code in order to say, hey, when this button does something, here's what's doing it. In order to change the view, all I have to do is come back here, and I can change this by saying view. Let's see, hold on. Let me back up a second. We're going to do an if statement to check whether the light on is true or false, and we're going to change the color depending on whether it's true or false. So we can say if, and we can use the Swift statement, and it gives us a little hint that we can do, if light on, and I can use, because it's a Boolean, I can treat it as its own. I can just say if true, then do this. And we're going to say view.backgroundColor equals, and when I use a dot, I'm going to be given the options. It uses an enum, which is a shortcut for a color. So what I'm saying here then is if light on is true, then change it else, and add a curly brace, press return, view.backgroundColor, and I'm just pressing tab when I get the autocomplete, and I'm tabbing again, equals, and then there's another enum, which is black. All right, go ahead and you can save that, and let's run this and see what happens. Okay, we have our button. I want to go ahead and press the button, and hey, check it out. It changed the background. All right, let's try it again. Hey, look at that. The light is on, the light is off. The light is on, the light is off. On, off, on. Okay, sorry. Very good. Let's go back and let's stop. Right now we have this logic that says turn or change the background color, and it's hard-coded in this button pressed method. It's better to organize your code so that you can have functions that do one item, one action, or a group of actions that are closely related that can easily be separated from other functions. You don't want to have one method that does hundreds and hundreds of things. You want to organize your code in a way that you can have other actions call the same thing, for example. If I had another button, or I had text or something that if it changed, I wanted to do a similar background color change, I don't want to duplicate this code. Instead, I want to make this its own method that I can call from anywhere in the code. So go ahead and select it and then press Control X to cut and go down here. And we are going to create a function called UpdateUI. And we're going to paste this code. Now I have a function that I can call from anywhere else to turn on the light. So now I go back to my button pressed and I'm going to say update UI, and there it is. Let's go ahead and run this one more time and make sure we didn't break anything. So we'll press the button. Hey, look at that. Hey. Oh, hey, oh, awesome. Okay, I'm going to take a break here. We're going to do another video because this is getting a little longer. So please subscribe, like, share, whatever else you do, please make add a comment. If you have any questions, I'll try to answer them as best I can. All right, thanks for watching, and check out the next video for our exciting conclusion to the Light project.